गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट, आई एम ओ वी आशीष कामरे, द असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स फ्रॉम कंप्यूटर साइंस डिपार्टमेंट. वेलकम टू अवर ई लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी डिस्कस द IoT आर्किटेक्चर. नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी डिस्कस द IoT आर्किटेक्चर इन अ प्रैक्टिकल केस. इवन बीइंग वन ऑफ द मोस्ट ट्रेंडिंग एंड इन्फ्लुएंशियल टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ इट्स टाइम, पीपल रियली नो अबाउट द टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स इन डेप्थ. While it is common knowledge that this technology assists in the creation of interconnected networks of devices, not many people know how the data really reached from end things to their mobile phones. As a practical case, we can describe the above 7-layer IoT architecture in a following way. First layer is sensor, next sensor to gateway network. Next layer is gateways. Next layer, gateways to internet network. After that, data ingestion and information processing. Next layer is internet to the user network. And after that, the last layer of the IoT architecture is value added information. Let's discuss all these 7 layers one by one. First, sensor. Sensor and other data collecting device from the initial layer of any IoT system. These are the interface between real and digital world, hence are responsible to convert analog to digital signal. There are different sensory device such as meter, sensor, probe, gauge and actuator that can read parameters like temperature, distance, location, humidity, etc. These devices are installed on endpoints, that is things, and collect required parameters in the form of raw data. Next is sensors to gateway network. This layer is the first network layer of any IoT system. It is responsible for transmission of data from first layer, that is sensor, to the third layer, that is gateways. The data is transferred from the sensor to gateway through a specific communication protocol with its unique rules, syntax, semantics and synchronization standard. The data transfer can only occur if both the sensors and gateway support the transmission protocol. Some common protocols that are used for connecting sensors with the gateways are like LoRaWAN, ZigBee and Sigfox. Next layer is gateways. Gateways are data aggregators that collect the data from the sensor and send it to the backend system. They are basically routers or modems that acts as a interface between local sensor environment and the internet. They collect data from sensor within their range and transmit it to the data ingesting platform. The need of gateways and sensor to gateway network is eliminated if the sensory device itself has a built-in gateway, or in other term, is capable of transmitting data to a large distance on its own. In a such case, the sensory device only required to read data and send it to the backend system. Next layer is fourth layer, gateways to internet network. Similar to the sensor to gateway network, this layer facilitates the transmission of data from gateway to the internet or backend system. This network may span over a wide area, allowing the transmission of data to far-off location. The protocol generally used for such a widespread network are Ethernet, Wi-Fi satellite, or cellular network. Next layer is fifth layer, data ingestion and information processing. In this layer, the raw data collect from the previous four layers is converted into manifolding information. The data in the most case is stored in a cloud storage and accessed through the backend system of mobile app or web application. The ingestion data is processed via advanced analytic and other processing system into a value added information which is displayed on the screen of the user. Next layer is internet to the user network. This is the final network layer, on layer of any end-to-end IoT system. The raw data stored in a cloud system is called by this network and displayed on the screen of the user in the form of value-added information. The protocol that are generally used for accessing the data from cloud storage system are Internet, Ethernet, and Wi-Fi. And last layer of the IoT architecture is value-added information. This final layer acts as fountain of whole IoT system. The collect data and value-added information is displayed on the screen of the user, allowing them to track the parameter pertaining to the asset they want to monitor. The information can be displayed in the form of number, graph, alerts, or character, enabling the user to derive useful insights and make smart decisions. The information can be accessed from any smart device such as smartphones or desktop via a unique IoT platform that is trailed with the features like real-time alert system, analytic, and remote monitoring. Thank you for watching my video. Keep watching my video.